Hey guys, so I'm about to do my wash and go over, and I wanted to show you guys how I do it. So the weeks that I do my wash and goes, I'll do it over 3 times, Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday. On Sunday, the only difference is that I'll cleanse my hair with a no suds, no sulfate shampoo. But on Wednesday and Friday, I'll use a conditioner, all natural conditioner. It's usually Tresemme Naturals or whatever natural conditioner that I have on hand. So what I'm about to do now, because this is Wednesday, so what I'm about to do now is to wash this out and redo my wash and go. So I usually, like I said, I usually use Tresemme Naturals out of Tresemme Naturals. So what I'm going to do is use the Trader Joe's Refresh Citrus Conditioner. So basically what I'll do is I'll wash my hair either once or twice with this. Then I will detangle, finger detangle in the shower with my deep conditioner, which also serves as my leave-in. And I use the Kinky Curly Knot today. So when I come back, I'll have my hair finger detangled with the deep conditioner that I use. So I just finished co-washing and detangling my hair with my fingers. That's one of the things that I absolutely hate to do, but I've been doing it for 3 weeks now, and I do recognize that I'm losing less hair when I do the whole finger detangling technique. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you can definitely look up videos on how to finger detangle on YouTube. So now what I have in my hair is the Kinky Curly Knot today. So with the Kinky Curly, when I'm doing wash and goes, I like to use it as a leave-in as well as a deep conditioning conditioner. So what I'll do right now is I will part my hair in two and kind of just pin it up, just trying to have my ends exposed on top. Okay, so now my hair is all pinned up, and what I'll do is sit under the steamer for at least 15 minutes and I will come back. I've also, if you don't have a steamer, what you can do is just place a hot towel on your head. If you want to just wring it out in the shower with some hot water and then put it over your head, it will give you a similar effect. So I'm about to go sit under the steamer and I'll be back. Hey guys, so I just finished sitting under the steamer for about 15 to 20 minutes. So my hair feels really soft right now, but the problem is that your cuticles are open. So basically what I'll do is I will spritz my hair down with aloe vera juice in a spray bottle just to bring the pH down so that I can seal the cuticles. And then I will apply my styler, which is my flaxseed gel that I make. And you can make this as well. There's a whole bunch of videos on how to make it on YouTube. You can look it up if you want. And then I will seal all of that moisture in with an oil. So I use castor oil because my hair is really thick and I like the way that castor oil kind of weighs my hair down a little bit. But if you have thinner hair or, you know, finer hair, you can use a lighter oil or you can just skip the oil. What I'll do now is I will section my hair off. Now, like I said, because I have thick hair, I section my hair in a lot of sections, but you know, you got to do what works for you. If your hair is finer or thinner, you don't have to section your hair in as many sections as I do. All right, so I'm just going to section this and then I'm going to show you guys how I apply my styler.
jibbing through in life. And it ain't no elementary thing. Gotta overstand why we representing your share. Because you got a lesson to bring, I listen and care. Cause I know the message and dreams is written between lives I can't see on a daily. And appreciation for vibes, I give intimate rhymes. The free to take them, I love your patience. Cause maybe time is made for waiting, who knows? But you know, the crew holds our heart and souls and mic tight grips like judo. Feels so real, my mind won't let it go.
Okay, so now I'm finished with the application of my styler and the aloe vera juice and the oil. So now what I like to do is just to squeeze out any excess water or aloe vera juice just so that it can dry a little bit faster. So that's what I do now. And I just squeeze it out with a t-shirt because you don't want to use a towel because it will frizz your hair. I just use a t-shirt. So now what I will do is I will flip my head over twice just to kind of separate out everything. So that's what I'll do now. Okay. So now everything is kind of separated and I'll try to part my hair in a way that I want it to look. Should have parted it before, I forgot. But I kind of have this part in my hair anyway. And I'll just do one pass of flaxseed gel over the crown of my head just to make sure that it doesn't frizz too much in my little problem areas. Especially up in here, I have problems with frizzing. So I'll just pass some flaxseed gel over those areas. You definitely have to mop up your floor after you use this gel because you drop a lot of it because it's kind of like an egg white. You kind of drop it. So that's one thing I don't like about it, but I only do it 3 times a week. So now it is good. And I'm just smoothing right now just to make sure that I try to get as much frizz as I can out of it. And now it is good. So what I will do is I will try to air dry it as much as possible. I'm pretty impatient, so after a while, you know, I can't do it anymore, but I'm gonna try to do it as much as I can. I have to go out tonight, so I'm more than likely gonna end up diffusing it, and I'll come back and show you how I diffuse it.